Welcome to this session. In this session, I want to teach some more problems based on in circle and x circles. Okay. First question is, if P1, P2, P3 are the length of the altitudes drawn from the vertices A, B, C to the opposite sides of a triangle respectively, then show that 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 plus 1 by P3 is equal to 1 by R and 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 minus 1 by P3 is equal to 1 by R3 and the third one is P1, P2, P3 is equal to ABC whole square by 8R cube that is also equal to 8 delta cube by ABC. Okay, let us see the proof of this. We are given that P1, P2, P3 are, we are given that P1, P2, P3 or P1, P2, P3 or length of the altitudes, length of the altitudes drawn from the vertices, drawn from the vertices A, B, C. Okay, consider a triangle ABC. Consider a triangle ABC. Here, AD is the altitude drawn through the vertex A and BE is the altitude drawn through the vertexes B and CF is the altitude drawn through the vertex C. Okay, we know that area of triangle delta is equal to half base into height. From this triangle, area of triangle delta is equal to half base into height. Okay. From this triangle, we can write delta is equal to half. Here, the base BC is the opposite side to the vertex A. So, BC is equal to small a and we are given that the altitude passing through the vertex A is P1. So, AD is equal to P1. Hence, base means small a and height means P1. So, area of triangle delta is equal to half small a into P1. From this, we can write 2 delta is equal to AP1 and P1 is equal to 2 delta by A. Similarly, we can find P2 is equal to 2 delta by B and P3 is equal to 2 delta by C. Remember it, P1 is equal to 2 delta by A and P2 equal to 2 delta by B and P3 equal to 2 delta by C. These three values are very much useful in solving objective problems. Okay, let us see the first condition, that is 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 plus 1 by P3 is equal to 1 by R. So, already we derived P1 is equal to 2 delta by A and P2 is equal to 2 delta by B and P3 is equal to 2 delta by C. Okay. First condition is 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 plus 1 by P3. What is the value of 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 plus 1 by P3? Since P1 is equal to 2 delta by A, then 1 by P1 is equal to A by 2 delta. Similarly, 1 by P2 is equal to 2 delta by B and 1 by P3 is equal to C by 2 delta. Okay, from this, consider the LCM as 2 delta. In numerator, we get A plus B plus C. And we know that A plus B plus C means sum of all sides, that is perimeter, that is denoted by 2S, 2S by 2 delta. Here 2 gets cancelled, this is equal to S by delta and we know that small r is equal to delta by S, hence S by delta is equal to 1 by r, this is equal to 1 by r. Therefore, 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 plus 1 by P3 is equal to 1 by R. Okay, let us go to the second one, that is 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 minus 1 by P3 is equal to 1 by R. Show that 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 minus 1 by P3 is equal to 1 by R. Okay, similarly, from first condition, 1 by P1 is equal to A by 2 delta plus 1 by P2 is equal to B by 2 delta minus 1 by P3 means C by 2 delta. Okay, here consider the LCM as 2 delta. In numerator, we get A plus B minus C. Since we know that A plus B plus C is equal to 2S, from that we can write A plus B is equal to 2S minus C. Here we have one more C, that is 2S minus C by 2 delta. Okay, this is equal to 2S minus 2C by 2 delta. In both numerator and denominator, taking 2 as common and then cancel. So 2 times of S minus C by 2 delta, here 2, 2 gets cancelled. And we know that R3 is equal to delta by S minus C. Hence, S minus C by delta means 1 by R3. Therefore, 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 minus 1 by P3 is equal to 1 by R3. Okay. Next, the third condition is P1, P2, P3 is equal to P1, P2, P3 is equal to ABC whole square by 8R cube, and which is also equal to 8 delta cube by ABC. So P1, P2, P3 is equal to, from the conditions, P1 is equal to 2 delta by A and P2 is equal to 2 delta by B, P3 is equal to 2 delta by C. Already we derived P1, P2, P3. Those are 2 delta by A, 2 delta by B and 2 delta by C. By substituting those three values, we get 2 delta into 2 delta into 2 delta. 8 delta cube by ABC. 8 delta cube by ABC. And this is also equal to 8 into, since we know that delta equal to ABC by 4R. ABC by 4R whole cube by ABC. Okay, this is equal to 8 into ABC whole cube by 4R whole cube means 64R cube by ABC. Here 8 ones, 8 8 cancel. It can be written as ABC whole cube by 8R cube into ABC. Okay, here ABC, ABC gets cancelled. Therefore, P1, P2, P3 is equal to ABC whole square by 8R cube, and this is also equal to 8 delta cube by ABC. 8 delta cube by ABC. These are the three conditions. First one is 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 plus 1 by P3 is equal to 1 by R, and 1 by P1 plus 1 by P2 minus 1 by P3 equal to 1 by R3, and P1, P2, P3 equal to 8 delta cube by ABC, which is also equal to ABC whole square by 8R cube. Okay, next we are going to discuss an important problems. Those are, if ABC are given, then find the values of R, R1, R2 and R3. That is the first model. The second model is, if R, R1, R2, R3 are given, then we can find the values of small a, small b, small c. These two models are very much useful in solving both IP and objective. Okay. Let us see the first model. That is, if we are given that a equal to 13, b equal to 14 and c equal to 15, then show that capital R is equal to 65 by 8 and a small r equal to 4, R1 equal to 21 by 2 and R2 equal to 12, R3 equal to 14. Okay. We are given that a equal to 13, b equal to 14, c equal to 15. Okay. Let us find the value of 2S. We know that 2S means perimeter, that is equal to sum of all sides which is equal to a plus b plus c. This is equal to 13 plus 14 plus 15. This is equal to 42. 2s is equal to 42. From this we can write s is equal to 42 by 2. Therefore, s is equal to 21. S is equal to 21. And next we can find the value of delta. From Hiron's formula, we know that delta is equal to root over s into s minus a, s minus b, s minus c. By substituting all these values, we can find the value of delta. That is equal to root over s means 21, s minus a means 21 minus 13 into s minus b means 21 minus 14 into s minus c means 21 minus 15. This is equal to root over 21 into 8 into 7 into 6. It can be written as 21 means 7 into 3, 8 means 4 into 2 into 7 into 6. Okay. It can be written as, here we have 7 into 7, that means 7 square, and 3 2s are 6 into 6, 6 square, and 4 can be written as 2 square. This is equal to 7 into 6 into 2 whole square over root. Here square and root gets cancelled. We get delta is equal to 7 into 6 into 2. Therefore, delta is equal to 6 2s are 12, 12 7s are 84. Delta equal to 84. Now, we have the values of s and delta. By using these two values, we can easily find the values of small r, r1, r2 and r3. We know that small r is equal to delta by s. This is equal to delta means 84 by s means 21. Hence, r is equal to 84 by 21 means 4. And small r1 equal to delta by s minus a, which is equal delta means 84, s means 21 minus a means 30. Hence, r1 is equal to 84 by 8. This is equal to 4 2s and 4 1s by 4 2s are 8. Therefore, r1 is equal to 21 by 2. R1 equal to 21 by 2. Similarly, we can find the values of r2, r3 and capital R. Next, we can find the value of r2. We know that r2 is equal to delta by s minus b. Delta means 84, s means 21 and b means 14. This is equal to 84 by 7. Therefore, r2 is equal to 12. 84 by 7 means 12. 12 sevens are 84. Hence, r2 is equal to 12. Next, r3 is equal to delta by s minus c. This is equal to delta means 84, s means 21 minus c means 15, which is equal to 84 by 21 minus 15 means 6. Hence, r3 is equal to 6 1s and 6 14. R3 is equal to 14. Next, we can find the value of capital R. Since we know that delta is equal to ABC by 4R. Delta is equal to ABC by 4R. From this, we can write capital R is equal to ABC by 4 delta. Okay. By substituting ABC and delta, we can find the value of capital R, circumradius capital R. Here we have A means 13, B means 14 and C means 15 by 4 into delta means 84. Okay. 14 ones, 14 six are cancelled and 3 fives, 3 twos are cancelled. By simplification, we get capital R is equal to 13 into 5, 65 by 4 twos are 8. Therefore, capital R is equal to 65 by 8. Hence, so small r is equal to 4, r1 is equal to 21 by 2 and r2 is equal to 12, R3 is equal to 14 and capital R is equal to 65 by 8. Okay, next we can prove if R1, R2, R3 are given, then we can easily find the values of A, B, C. That is also very much important regarding the board exams for 7 marks questions. Okay, let us see that second model. Before going to the second model, let us see a small results. Those are First one is prove that 1 by r is equal to 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 plus 1 by r3. Consider the RHS part, that is 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 plus 1 by r3. This is equal to, we know that r1 equal to delta by s minus a, r2 equal to delta by s minus b, r3 equal to delta by s minus c. By substituting those three values, we get 1 by r1 means s minus a by delta plus 1 by r2 means s minus b by delta plus 1 by r3 means s minus c by delta. Here by taking LCM as delta and in numerator, we get s minus a plus s minus b plus s minus c. This is equal to s plus s, 3s, and we take minus as common from the remaining three terms, we get 3s minus of a plus b plus c by delta, which is equal to 3s minus of a plus b plus c means 2s by delta. 3s minus 2s, s by delta. And we know that small r equal to delta by s and s by delta means 1 by r, which is equal to LHS. Therefore, 1 by r is equal to 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 plus 1 by r3. This is one of the condition which we used in the second process, second model problems. Okay. And the second result is prove that delta square is equal to r, r1, r2, r3. Consider the RHS part, that is r, r1, r2, r3. R, R1, R2, R3. This is equal to, we know that small r is equal to delta by s, R1 equal to delta by s minus a, R2 equal delta by s minus b, and R3 equal to delta by s minus c. This is equal to delta into delta into delta into delta, delta power 4 by s into s minus a, s minus b, s minus c means delta square. From Heron's formula, we know that s into s minus a, s minus b, s minus c is equal to delta square. Okay, this is equal delta power 4 by delta square means delta square, which is equal to LHS. Therefore, delta square is equal to r, r1, r2, r3, and delta is equal to root of r, r1, r2, R3. Okay. Next, we are going to discuss second model problems. That is, first one is R1 equal to 2, R2 equal to 3, R3 equal to 6, and R equal to 1. Then prove that small a equal to 3, b equal to 4, and c equal to 5. We are given that R1 equal to 2, R2 equal to 3, and R3 equal to 6, and R is equal to 1. We know that delta is equal to root of r, r1, r2, r3. Okay, substitute these values. R equal to 1, r1 equal to 2, r2 equal to 3, r3 equal to 6. This is equal to 3, 2 is 6, 6, 6 is 36, and root 36 means 6. Hence, delta is equal to 6. Okay, and we know that small r is equal to delta by s. By substituting r and delta, we can find the value of s. We are given that r means 1, and we already derived delta is equal to 6 by s. From this, we can write s is equal to 6. S is equal to 6. Okay. And we know that r1 equal to delta by s minus a. R1 equal to delta by s minus a. Substitute R1, delta, and s. Now we can easily find the value of small a. So R1 means 2 is equal to delta means 6 and s means 6 minus a. Here 2 1s and 2 3s gets cancelled. By cross multiplication we get 6 minus a is equal to 3. From this we can write a equal to 6 minus 3. Therefore a equal to 3. Okay. Similarly, by using R2 and R3, we can easily find the values of B and C. Okay. We know that R2 is equal to delta by S minus B. Substituting the values R2, delta, and S, we can get the value of B. when we are given that R2 equal to 3 and we already find delta equal to 6 and S is equal to 6 minus B. Okay, here 3 1s and 3 2s gets cancelled by cross multiplication. We get 6 minus B is equal to 2. From this we can write 6 minus 2 is equal to B. Therefore, B is equal to 4. B equal to 4. Okay. Similarly, we can find the value of C also by using R3. Since we know that R3 is equal to delta by S minus C. By substituting R3, delta and S, we can find the value of C. R3 means 6 and we already derived delta equal to 6 and S is equal to 6. Okay, here 6 1s and 6 1s cancel. By cross multiplication, we get 6 minus C equal to 1. From this, we can write 6 minus 1 equal to C. Therefore, C is equal to 5. Hence, A equal to 3, B equal to 4 and C equal to 5. Okay, let us see one more problem based on the second model. Now, the second model question is, in triangle ABC, if R1 equal to 8, R2 equal to 12 and R3 equal to 24, find the values of ABC. We are given that R1 equal to 8, R2 equal to 12 and R3 is equal to 24. Okay, from this we can find the value of small r. Already we derived 1 by r is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay, by substituting all these values, 1 by R1 means 8 plus 1 by R2 means 12 plus 1 by R3 means 24. From this, taking the LCM as 24 and in numerator, we get 3 plus 2 plus 1. This is equal to 6 by 24, which is equal to 1 by 4. 1 by R is equal to 1 by 4. By comparing on both sides, we get R equal to 4. R equal to 4. Now, we can easily find the value of delta. We know that delta square is equal to R, R1, R2, R3. R means 4. R1 means 8, R2 means 12, R3 means 24. This is equal to 4 into 8 can be written as 4 into 2 and 12 can be written as 4 into 3 and 24 can be written as 4 into 6. Okay, this is equal to 4 into 4 means 4 square and again 4 into 4, 4 square and 3 2 is 6 into 6, 6 square. Delta square is equal to 4 square into 4 square into 6 square. So, delta is equal to 4 into 4 into 6. Therefore, delta equal to 4 4 is 16, 16 6 is 96. Hence, delta is equal to 96. Okay. By using small r and delta, we can find the value of S. We know that small r is equal to delta by S. R means 4, delta means 96 by S. By cross multiplication from this, we get S is equal to 26 by 4. Here, 4 2s are 8 and 4 4s are 16. Therefore, S is equal to 24. S is equal to 24. And we know that R1 equal to delta by S minus A. And R1 means 8. And we get delta is equal to 96, S means 24 minus A. Here 8 1s and 8 2s, that means 8 12 8s are 96. By cross multiplication, we get 24 minus A is equal to 12. From this, we can write 24 minus 12 equal to A. Hence, A equal to 12. A equal to 12. Similarly, we can find the values of B and C also. Next, we can find the values of B and C by using R2 and R3. We know that R2 equal to delta by S minus B. R2 equal to delta by S minus B. By substituting R2 equal to 12, delta equal to 96 and S is equal to 24 minus B. Here, 12 ones and 12 8s are cancelled. From this, we get 24 minus B equal to 8. From this, we can write 24 minus 8 equal to B. Therefore, B equal to 16. B is equal to 16. Similarly, we can find the value of C also by using R3. R3 is equal to delta by S minus C. Here we have R3 equal to 12 and delta E means 96, S minus 24 minus 6. Here 24 ones and 24 fours are cancelled. By cross multiplication we get 24 minus C equal to 4. From this we can write 24 minus 4 equal to C. Therefore C is equal to 20. C is equal to 20. Okay, let us see one example that is show that 1 by r square plus 1 by r1 square plus 1 by r2 square plus 1 by r3 square is equal to a square plus b square plus c square by delta square. Consider the LHS part, that is 1 by r square plus 1 by r1 square plus 1 by r2 square plus 1 by r3 square. This is equal to, we know that small r is equal to delta by s, R1 equal to delta by S minus A, R2 is equal to delta by S minus B, and R3 equal to delta by S minus C. By substituting those values, since small r equal to delta by S and 1 by R means S by delta, 1 by R square means S by delta whole square. Similarly, 1 by R1 square means S minus A by delta whole square. Plus 1 by R2 means S minus B whole square by delta square, and 1 by R3 square means S minus C by delta square. From this we can write S square by delta square plus S minus A whole square by delta square plus S minus C whole square by delta square plus S minus B whole square by delta square plus S minus C whole square by delta square. Okay, here consider the LCM as delta square, and in numerator we get S square plus S minus A whole square plus S minus B whole square plus S minus C whole square. This is equal to S square plus, by expanding these three terms we get S square plus A square minus 2AS plus S square plus B square minus 2BS plus S square plus C square minus 2CS by delta square. Okay, it is equal to S square plus S square plus S square. 4S square plus A square plus B square plus C square. A square plus B square plus C square, and we take minus 2 as common. From the remaining three terms we get minus 2 times A plus B plus C by delta square. Okay, this is equal to 4S square plus A square plus B square plus C square minus 2 times of A plus B plus C means 2S by 4 delta square. Okay, this is equal to 4s square plus a square plus b square plus c square minus 2s into minus 2 minus 2s into 2s 4s square minus 4s square by delta square. Here plus 4s square and minus 4s square cancel. This is equal to a square plus b square plus c square by delta square. Therefore 1 by r square plus 1 by r1 square plus 1 by r2 square plus 1 by r3 square is equal to a square plus b square plus c square by delta square. Okay, thank you.